Hello students, in this video let us continue with the problems on student t distribution of module 5 joint probability and sampling theory. In the previous video we have already done two problems on student t distribution and we have also seen how to find the value of t of 0.05 or t of 0.01 for different degrees of freedom using the standard t distribution table. Let us continue with few more problems now. Third problem, the sample of 10 measurements of diameter, sample of 10 means n is 10, of diameter of a sphere gave a mean of 12 centimeter. Sample mean is given, so x bar is equal to 12. Standard deviation of 0.15. Standard deviation is represented by S, whereas S square is nothing but the variance of the sample. Find 95% confidence limit of the actual diameter. T of 0.05 is 2.262. In the beginning, I have given you the formulas regarding 95% confidence limits and 99% confidence limit. This is a direct problem. All the values required in the formula is given already. You need to put the values. X bar is 12, S is 0.15, T of 0.05 is 2.262 and N is 10, so root 10. If you calculate this, you get 12 plus or minus 0.1073. When you take 12 plus 0.1073, you get 12.107. When you take 12 minus 0.1073, you get 11.893. So the limits lie in the interval 11.893, 12.107 is the confidence limit of the actual diameter. So let us move on to the next problem. The 9 items of a sample have the following values. 9 items means the value of n is 9. So degree of freedom, v should be 1 less, it is 8. Here t of 0.05 of for 9 degrees of freedom is already written by seeing the table. In the exam, most of the standard values will be provided to you. If not, table will be given to you. So, the sample values of 9 is already given. Does the mean of these differ significantly from the assured mean 47.5? Assured mean means it is the mean of the population. Mean of the population means it is mu. 47.5. First, let us formulate the hypothesis. Let us take there is no significant difference between the sample mean and the population mean. Let us write what is given. N is given. Population mean 47.5 is given. X bar is calculated by sigma x by n. We have to add all the x's here and divide it by 9, n is 9, you get 49.11. So for the formula, t is equal to x bar minus mu by s into root n, we require s. So let us find s using the formula. S square is equal to 1 by n minus 1 into sigma x square minus sigma x whole square, sigma x square. That means each x square we have to add. I'll show you here. 45 square plus 47 square plus 50 square plus 52 square, 48 square, 47 square, 49 square plus 53 square plus 52. So square each term, then add it. If you add all that, you get the value as 21,762. Sigma x whole square. Sigma x means we have to add all the x. If you add all the x, you get 442, square it, divide it by 9 and simplify. S square you get as 6.8611. Value of s is the square root of it, which is 2.6194. Then put it in the formula. T is equal to x bar minus mu by s into root n. That is 49.11 x bar. Mu is 47.5 divided by 2.6194 into root 9. You get the value as 1.84, which is very much less than 2.31. Therefore, if it is less, the hypothesis is accepted. If it is more, the hypothesis is rejected. Now, the hypothesis that, what is the hypothesis we have taken? You have to write it again. The hypothesis that there is no significant difference between the mean and the sample of the population is accepted at 5% level of significance. Let us take one more problem. The random sample of 10 boys you take. The random sample of 10 boys had the following IQ. 70, 120, 110, 101, 88, 83, 95, 98, 107, 100. Does the data support the assumption of a population mean of 100 at 5% level of significance? Given T of 0.05 for 9 degrees of freedom is 2.262. So let us first formulate the hypothesis. Let us take the population mean mu is equal to 100. That is, let us first formulate the hypothesis that there is mu is equal to 100. Now, we have taken 10 samples. So, n is 10. X bar is equal to sigma x by n. We will add all these x's divided by 10. Gives 97.2. Then we need to find S square. As per the formula, 1 by n minus 1. N is 10, 10 minus 1 is 9. I have shown you in the previous problem. Each x you will square, then add. You get 96312 minus here 972 you will square, divide it by 10. You get 944478.4. S square is equal to 203.73, or value of S is 14.27. Let us put it in the formula. T is equal to x bar minus mu by S into root 7. X bar we have found it to be 97.2, and mu we have considered it to be 100. Root n is root 10. 14.62. We get the value as minus 0.62. In the beginning, we have seen we will consider the mod of it. That is, when I take mod, it is 0.62, which is less than the standard value 2.262. Therefore, we accept the hypothesis at 5% level of significance. Let us move on to the next problem. A group of boys and girls were given an intelligence test. The mean score, standard deviation score, and the number in each group are as follows. Here, mean, standard deviation, and the sample size for the boys and girls are given. Is the difference between the means of the two groups significant at 5% level of significance? The standard value for 20 degrees of freedom is already given here. So let us write what is given. X bar, see here X bar. If you see here properly, till now in all the problems we have taken a single sample. Here there are two different samples. A sample containing 12 boys, that is n1 is equal to 12, n2 is equal to 10. S1 is equal to 8, S2 is equal to 10, and X bar is equal to 74, Y bar is equal to 70. XY we will take. So all those values I have written here. So question is the difference between the means of the two groups significant? Is the difference between the two groups very large, which you can make out, or there is acceptance between the two? We have to find. So let us formulate first. The difference between the mean is not significant. The difference is not significant. That is what we'll assume. So H naught is equal to the difference between the means of the two is not significant. So the value of T, according to T test for two samples, the formula is X bar minus Y bar divided by S into square root of 1 by N1 plus 1 by N2. X bar is already there, Y bar is already there, N1 is there, N2 is there. So S we want. Now here S1 and S2 is given. S is calculated by the formula. S square is equal to N1 S1 square plus N2 S2 square by N1 plus N2 minus 2. All the values are given above there. If you substitute those values and then simplify, you get 88.4. The square root of 88.4 is S is equal to 9.4. Let us find the value of T now. T is equal to X bar 74, Y bar 70, S 9.4, 1 by N1 is 12, N2 is 12. We get the value as 0.9936, which is less than the standard value given, 2.086. This 2.086 is given here. So standard value already given. It is less than the standard value. Therefore, the hypothesis is accepted at 5% of level of significance. If you know the hypothesis, you can write here. The hypothesis that the difference between the mean of two groups is not significant. That is what we have formulated in the beginning of the problem. The hypothesis what we have assumed is accepted at 5% level of significance. Now let us take one more problem. 11 boy students are given test in statistics. They were provided additional coaching and then a second test of equal difficulty was held at the end of the coaching. Marks scored by them are given below. Now first you look at the table and read the problem again. So two type of problem we come across here in t-test, as with single sample, with two sample. If you see this properly, even though if the value of two tests are given here, the sample contain only 11 boys. That means this is a problem related to a single sample. From the same sample, two different tests are given. So this is a problem related to T test for single sample, not for the two sample. Later, does the mark give the evidence that student are benefited by the extra coaching? Test the hypothesis at 5% level of significance. So here 11 students were given a test. After giving a test, these marks were obtained and the teacher was not satisfied by the mark. So the teacher had given these 11 boys extra coaching to them so that they can understand the statistics properly. After giving certain amount of extra classes or the extra coaching, again a test was given and the set of marks were again tabulated. Now we have to find whether that extra coaching have helped the students or not. Let us see. First of all, two sets of values are given. So what we'll do? First, let us consider the difference between the test 1 and test 2 for each boy. So test 1 and test 2. Here 24 minus 23 is 1, 19 minus 20 is minus 1, 22 minus 19 is 2. So difference between, 3, difference between them we will mark it as x and note down. Since 11 boys are there, n is equal to 11. X is there, so x bar you can find by the formula sigma x by n. Formulate the hypothesis first. We will assume that students are not benefited by the coaching class. So the coaching class have not helped the 11 boys. Let us assume that. For the assumption, we can write it as mu is equal to 0. Since mu is not given here, we will assume this. The extra coaching classes have not helped, not benefited the student. So S square, let us calculate. So S square is equal to 1 by n minus 1, sigma x square minus 1 by n into sigma x whole square. If you calculate all this, you get the value of S as 2.1319. T is equal to x bar minus mu by S into root 7. X bar we have found it to be 1, mu is 0, root n is 11, s is 2.1319. If you calculate, you get some value which is less than 2.228. So this shows the what we have assumed is correct. If you get less than the table value, our assumption is accepted. If it is greater, assumption is rejected. So the hypothesis what we have formulated is accepted at 5% level of significance. Now what is the meaning of that? What we have accepted it true, it means students are not benefited by the extra coaching classes. Do not copy the values. Check it again using your calculator. If any differences are there, make the corrections. So few more problems are left in this. Let us finish it in the next video. Thank you.